So, now for the fun stuff, and of course, where fun is greater, we also have greater difficulty. Close all this, and now open up our game manager. Oops. And we need to go. Let's collapse everything. Let's go and create another class. And we're going to call this fill node public. And of course, it's a node, so it's going to have an address. And okay, let's start with this. So I don't want to be interacting with these nodes, so that's why I'm creating a few two new nodes, because this will going to have the job of always updating. Well, not always, at least updating a lot more than the others. And here's what we're going to say: list node, and let's start with fill nodes, and say new list fill node. And let's add it over here and say void handle fill nodes. Okay, let's leave it. Right now, let's go on to our top because we're going to need quite a few more variables. Let's see where we should add them. We have all of this. Let's add them over here. So we need. Let's have a debugger object, fill debug object. Just for now, and then we're going to have public bool add fill. Then I'm going to make it public so I can change this public integer pixels out, public integer max pixels, and float ft, and also I want a pixels. So onto our handle fill nodes, let's go and start adding the hard part. We're going to be adding into our FT plus time dot delta, or we can have a universal delta. We can change this later, doesn't really matter. And if our FT is greater than 0.05, because we don't want this to run on every frame, we want to run it every other so. Okay, we're going to be resetting to zero. Else, you're going to be returning back. So that means if you are over here, if you are resetting to zero, you're going to be also running everything we write below this line. If your fill nodes are empty, you don't have anything to do. Go take a coffee break or something. Let's do a for loop. Then, if we have. We're going to have for each fill node we have in there, we're going to let's assign our fill node over here, say fill nodes I, and let's take our node. CN stands for current node. We're going to take it, oops, and say f.x, f.y. And then here's the fun part, we're going to be start going downwards because water falls down. Or well, I'm saying water physics, but I guess you know you can say or sun physics, liquid physics, call them whatever you like. I don't really know the correct way to do it, so let's call them either water physics or liquid physics or whatever. It doesn't really matter. Okay, so we're always going to be going downwards. Then we need to find our the node that goes to go down. Or maybe let's add D over here. So we're going to do get node fx and our new y. If the down node is empty, that means we keep falling down. So n d dot is empty. The next node we're going is empty now. So I'll turn that to false. texture instance dot set pixel and dot d dot x d dot y, and we need a color, one more color. We can have the same color as the build color, but for now I guess let's go and say build color, fill color. You can assign this or use the same color, it doesn't really matter. Let's assign to cyan. Set pixel and then say add the fill color. Then on your FY, on your fill node itself, we're going to be changing the Y to the Y, to the new Y. Okay, or the X doesn't need to change because we're just moving downwards. Then on our clear nodes, which we have over here, we don't need to create a separate list that is going to empty our pixels because we already have a list. Okay, we're just going to run this script, this part of the script, before we actually clear our pixels. Then on our clear nodes, we're going to be adding our current node. If now the one below us, it's not empty, that means we've hit something. So we're going to want to move on the next one, so we are actually falling down, you know, or if we are on a decline, we're actually falling down. So let's call this df for down forward, and we're going to go and take f.x plus 1 and our minus y. So if df is empty, that means we're going to go there. Now this assumes that we're always going to be frequenting the right side. Okay, so that is our only trick. We'll see what we're going to say. Or actually, you know what? Let's go on, say, on the fill node. In here, let's say public bool, right is first, or maybe looking or going right. Anyway, let's call it moving left because we're going to use the same variable as the units. But for now, it's going to be start as false. And because we did this, we're going to have to encapsulate a few stuff. Let's see. Okay, so we're going to say integer x if f dot moving, or actually I want to say underscore x f dot moving left. If you're moving left, it's going to be minus one or one, and integer underscore x2 f dot moving left minus one and one, and let's maybe add this to x1. So df fx dot plus x1 going down. If df is empty, then df is empty. Now it's not empty, it's false. Texture instance dot set pixel df dot x df dot y and then fill color. Then we need to change our fy to the new y and the fx to, or let's do plus equals to the x1, and of course clear nodes dot add current node. Okay, else okay, we looked the one way, now we need to look the other way. So forward is not, now we need to check backwards. node, d down and back, db, get node, and let's create a few more of this integer, and maybe x3 f dot. And actually, no, we don't need to do that. We already have this. A get node f dot x plus x2 on c, and then say if db dot is empty, db dot is empty equals false, texture instance set pixel db.x, db.y, and then of course fill color. Fy now is going to be our minus y, and fx is going to be the x2 plus the x2. Clear nodes.add db. So we look forward, we look backwards, and then if all of those have a way, for now we can keep it like this. The only reason, the only problem is it's going to be recycling it. So what we can say, fill nodes dot remove f. We're going to change this, so don't worry, it's going to be a lot more performant. So take the handle fill nodes now, and on the update before the clear list, we're going to be adding handle fill nodes. Let's put this down here because we use this function, and let's maybe add first the build nodes, then the handle fill nodes. Okay, this will have a direct effect on how it's going to be, of, you know, how the level is going to be built. So what happens if you are actually already building a bridge and there's somebody already trying to fill it? Okay, so we need a way to test this though, so we need to make a debug. Let's go and say, let's bring back our handle, or no, let's use our debug object. Yeah, let's see what it was. Get node and candidate build handle fill nodes. Let's say over here void debug fill. If pixels out max pixels, add fill equals false, and then of course return. If not, then on our pt add by with delta, of course we can change that into the general delta we have, and if any pt is greater than, let's go 0.05f, so at least we have a you know, it's not that slow. We're going to be adding into our pixels and resetting our pt, else just return. So if it's time to add, because if we want to have 25 pixels, we don't want to have all of them created at the same frame, we want them to be created by time over time and over time. Okay, simple enough. Then we're going to do a node get node from wall position. We have our fill debug object, so we're going to use that. Fill nodes f new fill node, so f.x n.x f.y f n.y, and then of course fill nodes.add f, and yeah, apply texture equals true. This will work, we'll see if it doesn't. Debug fill, let's go into our update. Let's add it on top, although the change is only going to happen over here. So it doesn't really matter. And maybe we can add it over here. If add fill, debug fill, save, minimize, go over here. Let's create an empty game object. Let's add one of these. Bring it up somewhere over here. It's going to start from the center, of course. On the game, hit play. On our game manager, it's only going to add 25 max pixels. Let's say 25 and say add fill. And we have something wrong. We don't have add the fill object debug, which is this. Hit play again. Change this to 25. Okay. And see how this is going to fall down. We'll fix this as well. Don't worry. Let's change the fill color to something a little bit lighter brown. Like you're throwing sand on something. So maybe let's bring this up a little bit above, over here. Let's maybe zoom in, hit play, game manager. Actually, let's make this to 25 and hit add fill so it starts right away. And there's our sand, liquid or whatever. Of course, we don't like this, like this is unnatural. So to fix that, go over here, public int, T, and on our handle fill nodes, instead of removing, we're going to be saying f.t++. So every time you don't know where to go, instead of removing you, we're going to be saying if f.t is, we're going to be adding to your t, and if for 5 times you don't know where to go, then that means you are pretty much settled in. So stay there. Otherwise, keep falling. Okay. And now you'll think how much performance we can get out of this. So let's test it. And let's see it. Until it crashes, which never is going to be that, but anyway, you'll see. Feel free to increase the speed of the video. By the way, okay, as you can see, performance is not just good, it's just excellent. 74 frames. Also, let's say I want to be a wise guy. I think we have an issue with the left side though. So we need to fix that as well, I guess. Because it does seem that they don't really go. Oh, yeah. They do kinda prefer one way. But you can see that like this, yeah, it's not really that bad. Maybe we written something wrong, let's see. X1, and yeah, this should be, this is the same thing over here, from what I can see. Let me think, if you're moving left, yeah. But on the X2, this will be 1, and this will be minus 1. Yeah, I think that's it. Let's try it again. We can bring this on a more interesting case. Let's try it like this. Yeah, I think we might did something wrong over there. That's not really how it works. This works better, I believe. I don't like this at the moment, but maybe it has to do with the amount of pixels we are throwing. But still, you can see that it's not really a bad thing to do. It's not like it's working. We just need to tweak it a little bit more until we get the actual desired effect. Let's make somebody build the other way. That's not the other way. That's the other way. Yeah, so this line, I think we forgot to do something. DB is empty. DF is empty. Clear nodes. Okay, let's make it so. Let's write it exactly as I have it into my notes. So I don't remember which one. Actually, I'm just going to show you the two ways to do this if you want to have also a preference. So let's say df equals get node f.x minus 1 y if df is empty. I don't think it's going to make a huge difference, but let's see. Set pixel df dot x df dot y and then fill color f dot y equals y f dot x equals minus equals 1, then df is empty equals false, clear nodes dot add current node. If this is false, then BF get node F to text plus 1 Y if BF is, we need to cast this, BF dot is empty, BF dot is empty equals false, texture instance dot set pixel bf dot x bf dot y fill color, this will be now underscore as well fill color, and then of course we have bf dot y equals y f dot, yeah that's not it, underscore y f dot x plus 1, clear nodes, add current node, else f dot t plus plus, if f dot t is greater than 4, f dot, not f, fill nodes dot remove f. Okay, remove F and then let's see. Let me see the order I have the execution of the functions. Interesting. So I'm doing a slight, yeah, I'm kind of making this, I've written this slightly different. So I have the build list of nodes after my field nodes, and I even have the clear list of pixels. Let's see. Yeah, I have the clear list of pixels right as it is, something like this. It still doesn't matter because that's here where the visual appearance happens, and this changes of course every frame, so you know it doesn't really matter. Save. Let's try this then, and you can of course choose which one suits your game best. You can see that, yeah, I think it works, it looks a little bit cleaner, so this side is entirely cleaner, but the only problem is that they might prefer one way. But I think this is also, this looks a lot better. And of course, it's still, you can see that from performance wise, we don't really care at all. We are doing not just fine, really, really fine. We are at pixel level after all. Okay. Obviously, 73% is the update, but you know, we're still at 70 FPS, so you know, who cares? Okay, and it's basically understandable where the stuff, although you can see that this is from the VSync, so even if we remove our VSync. If we go into edit, projects, quality, don't sync. I probably should have hit record already. Okay, yeah, we are really doing fine. Awesome. Let's unlock this, clear that. And of course this can be, with this you can make a game of its own. You can even move this if you want to make it snow. I mean, don't do this, I like this idea, don't steal it. I'm joking of course. But yeah, you can see that it really really doesn't really matter or care what we've written, it's really performant. And yeah, we went out of bounds. And if you leave this, it will keep adding and adding and adding, and we can of course still keep changing our environment, and it will adapt, and it will adapt. And if we go to the game manager, you'll see pixels out. So let me pause the video and let me show you how many you can get. I'm actually going to yeah, that was a bad idea. We don't have any detection on the these guys, on the objects, on themselves, so it's a bad idea to, well, it's not a bad idea, it's just that if they fill, they're just not going to move anymore. Let's maybe keep them over here. Okay, let me pause the video, take a coffee break, and when it comes back we'll see how many we've added into the screen. So, as you can see, close to 3000. Okay, we really don't budge at all. We have around, I don't know, I've set this to 200. Let's maybe. Yeah, I think it was a bad idea to have this guy, but we can, of course, build a bridge above him. Because why not? We can do everything we want. That's the fun part of creating stuff. And somebody decided to go start digging. Okay, now we can start working towards there. Awesome. There is a little bit of a cluster over here, but who knows? Let's kill all of them. Maybe it was a bad idea to hunt the guy over there. Let's start building. Let's be more merciful, I guess. For one pixel, you can see that they can actually work over there. I guess it's more than one pixel. Oh, come on. Yeah, that's not going to happen, eh? Awesome. So, until everyone starts going back. Yeah, I forgot I've actually made this game and I can just move the spawn position. Sometimes I'm not really thinking. And yeah, that's not going to work because we only save the node once. But since we are above here, why not start digging? If you haven't noticed, I'm just showing off here, not really. But yeah, I think it's justified. We made this really cool thing. We have to show it off. It's just really, really nice. It's one of the best things I've done, actually. Well, okay, I've done other cool things as well. There's a few bugs over there, but who cares? We have all this nice stuff. Come on, let's dig. Oh yeah, they don't dig if they're going upwards. They don't dig because they have to go. They have to find more pixels to block their way. But I hope I convinced you on how cool this is and to what extent we can do things with just this technique. I mean, you name it, there's plenty of games that use pixel perfect collisions. Well, actually not that many, but from now on there can be many, because why not? Okay, so let's see how much what we do with this. The only thing that's going to give you an error is if any of these fill nodes get out of bounds, then we don't have anything to avoid that. Okay, we're going to fix that as well. You can see that we have almost 8k pixels out. Doesn't matter how much you add, the only problem is if you run out of bounds. So, close this. Close this and let's go into our game manager, into handle fill nodes, and basically we need to say if the get node, if CN is null, and then remove fill nodes dot, just remove it entirely. F, continue. Okay, so skip this one. Let's test this as well. And to test it, we're just going to go. Let's bring it over here. Let's see if we get an error if they go down. Yeah, we did. Let's see where the error is. Oh, this gets you the current. So just take this and put it down here. So the one below doesn't exist. Close, save. Check your emails and then try again. Okay, awesome. And this will just run until until it has removed all your fill objects. Awesome. So let's keep the add fill. And basically, we want to say, let me think, we need to kind of make it so you know that we have different instances. So I'm going to take this part of the code, well, most of it, and add it inside my unit. So on to our, yeah, we don't have it. Let's create it. Void filler float delta. And let's bring back our, well, we need our references, ability stats. We want to have float. Let me find them again. Actually, you know what? Come here, new vertical tab group. And let's go on to the top. Pixels in, maximum pixels. Okay. So, public float. Let's start with the integers. Integers, pixels out, public integer, max pixels, set it to 25. And then we have float fill t, and then of course float p and t. So on to the fillers. Let's bring this down below again. If pixels out is greater than max pixels, change ability and go back to being a walker again, not the whiskey kind. And we add with Alderta if p t is greater than 0.05f pixels out plus plus p by t equals 0. Because we add with this delta, that means if we change the time scale, it also going to have the, yeah, it's going to also add it as slow motion, if we have a slow motion, else return. Okay, and then node n, get node, yeah, we don't need node from all position. This is what we have to think a little bit. So let's say integer, actually let's write the stuff we need over here. Let's say node n, let's assign it to null over here first, then fill node, new fill node, f.x, n.x, f.y equals n.y, fill node.add game manager fill, yeah, we don't have a fill node. Let's go, and we are already there, so let's not go there. Public void add fill node, fill node f, fill node dot add f. Okay. So over here, say game manager dot add fill node f. And because we add a fill node, that's a little bit tricky. No, it's not, because it already has an apply texture. It has the fill node, so the fill nodes will see that they need to apply the texture. And so on, so on. Awesome. Let's close the game manager, and here's where what we need to think of now. The X, depending on if we are moving left or right, and it's going to be current node. Come on, current node dot X minus one. Otherwise, current node dot X plus one, And the y is going to, I'm just going to take my current node dot y and add, I think 2 pixels should be enough. So this will now be game manager dot get node x and y. Okay, awesome. Yeah, this will do. Okay, so the filler only has to just keep adding. Then you're going to change I don't think I want to change that. Yeah, we have an animation there, so we might not want to change, right? Or we might just ignore that animation and only play this. So, filler. Let's create one more thing, which is going to be public float fill start, I think something like 0.6, and then float fst. So if you are playing the filler, before you do anything, you're going to say okay, let's add one more thing. I don't want to be checking through the animator to do this. That's why I'm adding these things over here. Say bool start filling. If not start filling, equals not equals. If fst is lower than f start filling, not start filling, fill start, fs basically start filling equals true, and fst plus delta. Okay, so when we are changing our ability for the filler, we're going to be saying anim.play fill start, start filling equals false, fst equals 0, f t equals 0, and then basically we need to say pixels out equals 0. And PT should be also 0. We're basically just resetting everything. Okay. Git node, git manager. So this probably is going to work. Let's see the animation name on the animator. Filler. It's just filler, not filler start. So let's change this to filler. From the filler, it's just going to go into the loop until the timer, or we have thrown as much as pixels we want out. So get this, and let's change the max pixel. Okay, let's make this to 80, just for fun. And open this out, hit apply, and fill start. Let's find the correct number for fill start. We're going to go animation, filler. It's basically just until it reaches this frame and passes this frame, so it's one more, so 0.5 should be, or let's leave it at 0.6. okay, so we'll give it one sample of, let's bring the spawn position above over here, so we're throwing stuff down because why not, that's how we roll. Maybe over here. So we have a little bit of time to fill. Okay, let's go to the game manager. This will only work for the debugger. So, you know, we don't really have to change them. So we hit play, filler. And I think that's dry. Unless we forgot to do something, Let's find him. Let's close the canvas. Find this guy. Let's see his debug. What it's doing. Start filling. Maybe we didn't add. Yeah, I think we forgot to add. Oh, yeah. It will have help if we did this as well. Delta save, minimize. I think we throw up everything. And let's see. I think it was a little bit off. Let's bring him up. Well, basically, okay, let's play this. Let's do this. And let's go to this guy again. Close the canvas. So we want to come from over here, but if we add 1 pixel, it means we start from here. And even if we add 2, it means we start from here. But we want to start from here, so this is 1, 2, 3. So go back again on to our changeability. Not into our changeability, into our filler ability. Over here, say -3 or +3, +3. Yeah, I guess there's a little bit more issues or stuff to worry about, and I think yeah, it's a little bit too fast as well. And for some reason, it worked on the air. Oh, it didn't work on the air. It took this, so. I think we can only make them empty or not empty if they have settled down, so you can just run through all of this. Let's see how we can do that then, or maybe we can leave it for the next video. We'll see if it's yeah, it's empty. Let's leave this at that, and instead of doing this, BF and DF, and this should be no, delete this as well or comment it out and say F CN dot is no. Basically, just do another CN, get node, fx, fy, dot y, CN dot is empty equals false. So it will only take into account nodes that are actually empty and or they have settled down. Let's see what this is going to do then. This might give us a few problems, actually. Like this. Yeah, it's not really ideal. So maybe we can change this to 15, because why not? Delete this. Oh well, let's call it a feature instead of a bug, because that's what pros do. Save, minimize, hit play. And let's do this one more time. Okay. And now they will just keep falling. At least they're going to be until they settled we're going to have a lot of time. So, if you have a wise guy over here that is going to dig, yeah, the water waves are just doing whatever, so ignore them. We need to think of something there. And somebody starts digging down, and you want to save them. Come on. Let's actually save them then. Let's make him dig this as well. Let's leave it. Oh, here's our saviors. Which they can't go up. Start building. Okay. And just keep throwing and keep throwing. Oops. And keep throwing. And keep throwing. And keep throwing. And keep throwing. Awesome. So we saved our guys. Let's make them dig. Awesome. So let's leave it this out over here. As you can see, we do have an actual game, almost a game. We need to fix a few bugs, of course, but that's always that always needs to be done. And let's leave it. Let's stop over here. We've done quite a lot of things. I've shown you two ways you can make the liquids, but I think I prefer the one I've settled in for. This is really cool. I hope you can understand how much things you can do over here. Okay. And then, well, that's it. If you like to see more, well, we're going to work a little bit more with this. We're going to actually make menus and, you know, make it like it's an actual game that you can select levels. And yeah, you know what to do. Like, subscribe. If you like to see more, if you like for me to be able to keep making all this nice stuff and making even better stuff, then consider supporting me on Patreon or via Gumroad. I'll see you next time.